Welcome back, Dark Souls fans, to Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls 3. I remain your host, ShadowFury333, and let's give that deep braille tome to...
Ash, welcome back. Do you wish to hear a tale? You only have to ask.
To her.
Oh, what's this? Champion of Ash, this divine tome is forbidden.
Yeah, I know.
These are dark tales of things that lurk deep within men. These stories would not please you.
You said that about the last dark tome, and you were right, but still.
Of course, if you insist, I will read them for you. Only... they frighten me so.
Yeah, sorry about that.
The little creatures that nibble at me in the darkness.
We've talked about this before. All right, what's new? Saw that one. So it's Na and Deep Protection. Huh. Summon insect swarm to feast on foes. These insects which lurk in the deep have tiny jaws lined with fangs to tear open the skin and burrow into the flesh in the blink of an eye, causing intense bleeding. Oh! Right! That thing that those annoying priest things do.
Have a pleasant check.
I almost want to get it just to get them back with it. Use their own miracles on them. Anyway, we are done for now in Firelink Shrine, although I did remember something I picked up. I was curious about Exploding Bolt. Bolts that explode on impact deals area fire damage in the immediate vicinity. Due to the risk of detonation, the amount of bolts the user can carry is greatly limited. These are, after all, prototypes created by the weapon craftsmith Edmund. You get what you pay for. Oh wow, that's a lot of fire damage. And you can only hold 30, and I don't know where you get them. I almost don't want to use them until I can get more. I am curious what they do, though. So I'll slot them into the standard bolt slot. And use them against, I don't know, first enemy we find, I guess. I do kind of want to know if, okay. I kind of want to know if maybe, just maybe, they cause stagger that I can do a critical attack in, but I kind of doubt it. It'd be nice, but I doubt it. It's not a thing that Dark Souls 3 seems to allow you to do. Which is disappointing. As I mentioned before, I am disappointed. Anyway, back to the cathedral. Back to this lower area here where the elevator goes to. Or is it upper? It's upper! Never mind. Back to the upper area that this leads to. Apparently I and I alone know what I mean. Oh, this is back. Took the time to rebuild it in the time they had. Yeah, the problem is that this enemy's probably going to... Oh, well, yeah, that was kind of the problem. The enemy's going to die if I use that. I guess I could try it against one of those annoying priests. And you... Oh, I missed. Why am I even using this? Oh, right, that's why. Because you suicide bombed me! I do not want that to happen. Again. Bad enough the first time. Alright, let's check out what's down here, I guess. Mimic gun. That would have been a good test case, too. That's relatively slow telegraphed attacks. Oh, hey you. That was a warning shot. That was the real one, and I kind of wish I had standard bolts on, but I don't. Oh well. You're dead. Too bad for you. Alright, where is the next thing that I have to deal with? I guess that explains where that was. Oh, you, and also you. Well, hey, I got something to test this thing with, hey! We're good for ambushes? These little thieves done? Hmm. Ow. No, exploding bolts do not do anything super special, so... Yep. But this do- oh, well, it would if I'd actually, you know, hit. Oh. Ow. Oh, thank goodness, that was way too close. Oops. Did not want that to happen. I was trying to do the critical attack. Like, kicking the shield does open them up for a critical attack. That's what it does. That's what I wanted it to do. It's not what ended up happening. I'm very disappointed in myself right now. Not thoroughly disappointed, just very disappointed. There are grades of disappointment. It's like, actually not even that. I'm very disappointed. And thirdly would be way too far. Alright, what's out here? Okay, I'm getting kind of paranoid. I'm just gonna... Okay, first off, I'm gonna get rid of the torch because I don't really need it. And it might get in my way. It'll kill me in a fight. Like, no doubt about it, it'll kill me in a fight. I don't need the exploding bolt. I don't need fire that desperately. And it doesn't do anything super special. And you're gonna be a pain in the ass if I let you live. But you're gonna be a pain in the ass if I don't kill you right now. So I'll kill you right now. You are now... Oh, whoops. The heck? Anyway. Where was I? Oh yeah, killing you. Wow. Didn't hit you that hard, did I? Oh, how many more of these thieves are there around here? They're everywhere. It's getting kind of annoying. And, of course, the poison stuff. Is this anything? No. Nothing particularly special. And you're just dead. Okay, that's a poison lake. Or at least I am nearly certain it is a poison lake. Because what else would it be? It's green! Let's just double check. Oh, it's not poison. Okay, it's just slow. Which is about as bad, so... In the absence of a rusted iron ring, as I mentioned before, although I have a feeling I'm gonna find it here, because this seems like it's where I was supposed to go and not Farron Keep. Farron Keep, apparently, as far as I can tell, was way further into the game, or at least the intentions that you get to it way further into the game. And I basically was too early. As far as I can tell. I might be mistaken, but as far as I can tell, I was far too early when I got to Farron Keep. Which is why all my complaints about, oh, this is over-leveled, or rather, I'm not leveled high enough, I'm under-leveled, were valid. And I probably should have taken them and thought, well, why does it feel like it's under-leveled? Where else could I have gone? But then I did also point out, I don't know where else I could have gone. But now I do. And I like this area a lot. I like the architecture of this area. It loads. This is what I was hoping after High Wall of Lothric. I would hope it'd be another level kind of like that. Kind of ornate gothic. It just... Is this gothic? Well, I think... there are buttresses. Yeah, it's gothic. Okay. Hey, that's... I think... just about Dingy Skirt. Let's double check the description. White skirt worn by traveling maidens. Part of their formal attire regardless of rank. It is soft and well-made, but ill-suited for use in battle. Hmm. Not that ill-suited. Yeah, relatively speaking, it doesn't really hurt much. Anything, it actually makes magic and lightning better defended against. I'm curious if that's what I'm looking for. I'm not sure. I kind of want something more blue. That's not bad. That's actually pretty good. I mean, fashion souls-wise. Defense-wise, no. This is actually a really terrible combination. I should probably put on something a bit more substantial. Ah, and Lothric Knight's too heavy. Well, Lothric Knight's too heavy with my current gauntlets. Oh, no, there's... no. Right, that's right. It's the sword. That the the super cool Artorias Greatsword thing. That's not really suitable, sadly. And that's the only other better gauntlets I've got, which are actually slightly worse in some ways, and only slightly better in the ways I'm already covered for. It looks okay. This is kind of paladin armor. The herald stuff. Whatever. I think sellsword's my best bet. That or fallen knight, although fallen knight has the problem of being... sellsword is my best bet. Fallen knight's great for fire, though, but I don't think fire is a big threat here. Alright, let's stick with sellsword for now. Hopefully I'll find elite knight. Admittedly, that will have similar weaknesses to what I'm dealing with right now, but I think it'll be overall better. What's in here? Is this the shortcut back to the front? Please let it be the shortcut back to the front. And... maybe? Either that or a boss fight. How many embers do I have? I could check. In case... Ashen Estus up. Okay, so I want a lightning spear, whatever's past these doors. Kill the hell out of them. Hey! Wait, no, this is something new. This is not what I was expecting, but... Saint Bident. More story time! Where is the Saint Bident? It's in here somewhere, I saw it. Put it in my inventory. Oh, wait a sec. Okay, I saw it, but maybe it's not for my inventory of weapons. I don't see it. Seemed pretty... Oh, there it is. A silver bident decorated by a holy symbol, formerly wielded by Saint Klimt. He discarded this weapon, that draws upon one's faith, on the day that he put his own faith behind him. And it's charged, standard spear thing. A lot of faith. Curious how much damage it would do for me. I mean, I doubt it'd be super useful. I don't plan to use it. Yeah, stabby. Okay, pretty standard spear. Yeah, it's all spear. And then, in case you're wondering, because I never really showed it off, this is the charge. It was in Dark Souls 2, specifically with a Pate spear item, but. It's only in Dark Souls 3 as a spear weapon art. Anyway, let's go back to something a bit more sensibly sized. I say as I bring up my 2.5 meter long greatsword. Okay. Where is... Oh, I see. That's why I said praise the sun. Because it looks nice. It is a gorgeous view ahead. As I shall also put down... Where the heck was gorgeous view anyway? Ah, here it is. Visions of gorgeous view. Alright, go back. Up the stairs, back around, no shortcut here. But I got a bident that would help for if I was doing a spear build with this character. Because, hey, faith-based weapon. Scales of faith. Actually, I didn't even notice. Is that magic as well? It's gotta be magic damage. Alright, it's the historic greatsword, which does not help me at all because it doesn't scale. Okay, that is... No, pure physical. What? Really? Wow, I thought it'd be physical and lightning or magic. Probably physical and magic, but whatever. Alright, over here I go. I feel like the longsword is better for single enemies like this thing right here. Oh, shoot. There's a thief over there, thus my hesitance to stay here. Ow! Ow! Run! For the time being, and then I'll heal up, and then we'll be fine. Well, I guess we won't be that fine. Ow! Well, I got poisoned at least. Panicking here. I can't see, darn it, camera. There's not room. I can't... stupid camera! I don't know what else I could do other than go through the actual area and get... Oh, okay. Ow. Yeah, other than going through the walls, I don't know what it could do, but it's just... Yeah, it's killing me! It's literally killing me, or at least causing me damage that I wouldn't have otherwise taken if I could have seen where I was! Hey, these hallways are nuts. Really great for fighting. If I could clear out this flooded area, it'd be a lot easier. Alright, there's the thief thing. Large soul. I'm getting a lot of... I hadn't really got a lot of solid souls before. Ow. I need to ember up. I'm so low on health. I just don't wanna. I know I'm gonna die as soon as I do. And I probably won't die as soon as I do, but I just... I don't know. I don't feel like I have enough embers. Okay. Is there anything else I'm missing around here? Probably. It's probably illusory walls or something. Or non-illusory open paths. That's another option. Of course the giant respawns. I guess it respawns when you reload the game, or is that another giant? Oh. What? Oh. Neat. Okay, that's the next path opened, I guess. Of course, that giant's existence is bugging me right now. I guess I have to go up to get to it. Didn't even realize I was missing a path, but I guess I was. Okay. I know, I could probably level up my vigor, but at the same time, I need to level up dexterity so I don't have to use the Karthus Milk Ring anymore. As I mentioned before, I don't really like not being able to see where I am as I'm rolling. I don't need the dex. Oh no. Okay, this is what the torch is for! Where's the torch? There's the torch. Arguably also what the crossbow is for, so you know what? Screw you. I hate these maggoty things. I currently can't target onto. Yeah, let your tail be your undoing! Okay, let's not go down there until I know how to get back up. I think over here? Oh, this is probably a way to get back in. Another door doesn't open from the side thing, probably. Maybe? I don't know. Another elevator. Neat. Oh, maybe this is a door. Oh! This is back to the bonfire, I think. Maybe? Hopefully? I don't know. No, it's not. What am I thinking? It is! Holy crap, it is! Which means I can actually go around the other side. Maybe I'm dealing with the giant that way. I don't know. Let's find out. Because now that I know the giant's alive, and I didn't even notice before, I can kill it. So yeah, it looks like... Some enemies, seems like they respawn based off of you quit and reload. Like, Titanite lizards do, and they generally have. But so do, I think, Black Knights, because I did notice some of the Black Knights while exploring around trying to figure out where to go. The one in the Road of Sacrifices also respawns. And other enemies do. Like, enemies respawn. Or no. Oh, right, I'm losing track of where I am. Okay, so the giant I care about is over there. But there's upper areas. I might be able to get around to it. Looping around in a circle here. But maybe I missed something. Maybe I missed a thing Although, admittedly, it's a thing by that stupid priest enemy that I hate fighting, but maybe, just maybe, I can get through and not die. Odds are low, but I'm going with maybe. And obviously I have to kill it. Although I didn't see this giant last time, so I don't know. I can scout it out before I get up there. Let's just scout that out. Looks very unlikely. Well, I can gamble it. Oh! Perfect! Well, I was right. Short of there being illusory walls around here somewhere, I was right. This is not a suitable area to attack from. Alright. So much for this. Worth a shot. Is that really the case? I guess that is. Sheesh, this is a giant cathedral. This is like two basilicas. It's way more than a cathedral. And even basilicas would be... Actually, maybe basilicas would be about the same size. I'm not totally sure. But, yeah. This is absurdly massive. Alright, so let's just go around to where I was. Basically right there already, so it's not a big deal. Ay. Like, two big worship areas, which apparently have no altars. Wait a sec, so this goes out to... Well, this is new. There you... Oh, whoa! I was wondering, okay, where's the enemy? And it's a cursed spider of some kind. Okay. Aldrich is staff fire. So those don't remember from the intro, Aldrich was the goo monster. What is this? A reformed ring left by Aldrich, Saint of the Deep, recovers FP from critical attacks. Aldrich, infamous for his appetite for flesh, apparently had the desire to share with others. His joy of imbibing the final shudders of life while luxuriating in his victim's screams. That sounds really handy. Dark as hell, but handy. I mean, granted, I'll need another point of dexterity to be able to not have to use the Karthus Milk Ring, but... Dropping that, maybe. Don't use critical attacks a whole lot, but, you know, not having to worry about FP cost for it, that'd be nice. Because like, you enter a room and you think, there's something. There's something around here. I know there's something. Because there's got to be something. I mean, that's just how it works, right? You go into a room and nothing's trying to kill you, something's wrong. You miss something. And I did. That was quite something. Alright, so... Found the shortcuts, but I'm fairly certain those weren't the only paths. I missed an elevator. Completely bypassed that, so we'll take that, and hopefully that'll bring us up to the path and allow us to fight the giant from above. Oh, what? Really? Oh, yeah, that's right. Oh, this area. Okay, yeah, I remember this. This is right, like, if you go through the hallway right there, and then go a bit beyond, that's where the Titanite Lizard was. That's where I fought that. You know, side note, yeah, so you can see it right here, the graveyard. Side note, should I be using I or we? I notice a lot of Let's Players use we. I'm never sure if I'm thinking, if this is meant to be kind of a collaborative thing or a performative thing. Like, Is the idea that we're all, that you guys watching and me are together doing this thing? Or is it that I'm putting on a show? I guess it really is more kind of collaborative because, I mean, I'm the one directly doing it, but you guys have your comments and... Yeah, I guess I'll use we. I can kind of see the logic behind that. Alright, so yeah. This feels weird to me. I don't know. Like, I literally have far more experience doing stage performance than I do doing Let's Play stuff. Which, granted, isn't saying much, but... Not the commentary stuff, I mean, specifically Let's Plays like this. But... Yeah, it's kind of a weird question. Anyway, 5,000. How many solid souls do I have? I got a lot of solid souls. I noticed I didn't really get a lot of those in the catacombs, nor did I get them a lot in the Smoldering Lake. So I feel like I've been missing them a lot recently. Anyway. But yeah, that Titan Lizard's down the path. Kind of saw that. So, at the end of the addendum side note. Is there a place to jump off here? Hang on. Ow! Man, you're annoying. I was trying to figure out if I could jump off anywhere. If you want to jump down, be my guest. Usually open elevators like this in Souls games and FromSoft games, they're usually a hint that you can jump off somewhere. But apparently this is an exception. Eat my sword. Alright. Huh? Oh, is there something on the walls? Nope. Not here. Oh, I see where I am. Okay. Right, this spot. Which is where the... That is where I came in. Right there, center screen. Like, that's the mausoleum area. That's where I came in. Oh, this level is so well designed. Love it. This is what I wanted to see after High Wall of Lothric. More stuff like this, because High Wall of Lothric was like this too. It's like, actually, this is better. More wraparounds and such. Oh, I'm so happy about this. Deep ring. Getting all the rings. All right. A ring bestowed upon the deacons of the Cathedral of the Deep allows attunement of additional spells. In the cathedral slumber, things most terrible, and as such, the deacons require a grand narrative to ensure they do not falter in their duty. A philosophy to ward away the madness beckoned by the grotesqueries at hand. Darn right you do, that stuff's terrifying. So, I have both Saint's Ring and a Deep Ring. I can actually, for the cost of two ring slots, attune more spells, but quite honestly, at that point, just get more attunement, because you're going to need a lot of mana to do that. Alright, so there's no other real purpose to this area other than the Deep Ring. Which, admittedly, is still kind of handy if you don't want to pay for the Saint's Ring or you want to have two spell slot rings. So, like, okay, I should say, if your attunement's like 11 or something, which mine is, then... 14, my mistake. If it's, you know, high enough to get some spells but not high enough to get, like, 5 or 6 spells, then it seems to make more sense to me to get more attunement to get the FP to actually cast the spells. But if you're going heavy spellcaster build and you have like attunement of 30 or something with 5 or 6 attunement slots by default, another 2 attunement slots might not be a bad idea. I actually haven't tested what happens because I haven't had a chance to, being that I don't have copies of spells, to see what happens if you have multiple copies of a spell. My guess is that in order to preserve the same kind of feel of the earlier games where they had the Vancian magic system, they probably have the FP cost halved. Or rather, reduced fractionally. Because in the earlier games, it was just you had multiple copies of a spell that allowed you to cast it that many more times. So every spell had a certain number of casts. Like, say, Lightning Spear started out with, I believe it was 8 casts? No, 6 casts. Dark Souls 2 kind of messed with it because Dark Souls 2 added another scaling system with attunement where if your attunement was higher, you'd get additional spell slots based on your attunement, on top of having... Oh, sheesh, I think I know what's going to happen here. So you'd have, like, say Lightning Spear would be 3 at first, then you got your attunement for 31, and it'd be 4, and then as you raise your attunement, your number of spells you could cast, or number of times you could cast it went up. It was kind of absurd, although honestly the FP system is a similar concept, in that you get more spells and more spell slots, and more ability to cast spells all at once. Yeah, Dark Souls 2 did a similar thing. And in Dark Souls 2, I remember it was like, say, 4 for Lightning Spear, and then another 4 for another. So you had 8 if you had 2 of them, if you had like 31 attunement or higher. I think in one it was six per... Anyway, it doesn't really matter. So if you had, like, say, five per spell, you attune three of them, you have 15. It's just, it's linear multiplicative, really simple. My guess is that it's the same idea, whereas if I had, say, three copies of Lightning Spear attuned, or three copies of Heal, it would cost me a third of the amount of mana. If I had four copies, it'd be a quarter. If I had two copies, it'd just be a half. It's my guess. Is there a staircase up here? I thought I saw one. Okay, I'm not blind. But I am gonna have to deal with this super slow water. Okay, there it is. Oh, sheesh. I should have paid a bit closer attention. Okay. Can I? No, just the legs, apparently. Huh. Drang, I guess, as in Drang Lake. Oh, why can't I roll three? What the heck? What is this madness? Great, well, at least I can run. Oh, crap. All right. Also, don't need this anymore. Not for now, at least. I am not well suited for this right now. I do not have very much Estus. I do not like that fact. I'd have to live with it. Are you gonna die? Are you taking damage? Aren't some word immune tanking everything state? Oh, I'm out of stamina. That's why I can't do anything. What, do I have a limited number of bolts I can fire? Yes, I do. It's dictated by my stamina. Because that's how crossbows work again. Okay, alright. Get out! I don't know how much damage I'm dealing. At least you're dead. You know, I don't have very many of these, but this seems like a perfect time to use them. Oh, yeah! Oh, you're not dead yet? Okay, now you're dead. What is going on? What? Oh, shit. Okay, I guess that it technically hit me. Hey, another heavy piece, or semi-heavy piece of armor. Might be able to get some use out of this. Ow. Oh, boy. I have no idea what this thing's health bar looks like right now. Hardly changed. I guess it must be invincible when it's normal. Oh, shoot. Am I done? I'm done. I'm so done. I have no Estus. I have no magic. And there's no bonfire path available to me right now. No. Not good. Okay, shoot. I'm gonna go back the way I came. I think. I don't know for sure. But I think I do. Oh, right. What the hell does this thing have? Okay, I'm gonna just assume that when it's not active, it's invulnerable. Like when I don't see the, if I don't see the health bar, it probably doesn't exist. I don't know. If I just get rid of this thing, it'll make life a lot easier. Ah, shoot. Stupid goo. Ah, I hate these goos. Oh yeah, apparently it's invincible when it's down. Okay, good to know. Oh, you're annoying. Crap. Well, if it wasn't dead before... Oh right, Homeward Bones exist. I have a way of dealing with this right now, so I'll just use that way of dealing with it. Still some of those annoying goos, but at least they're mostly gone. Oh! Yeah! Oh, come on. Oh, deals a minuscule amount of damage, but it does deal damage! This would have taken for bloody ever if I had actually done that way. Alright, where are the remaining goos so I can get rid of them before they get rid of me? So one over there, one over there. Ooh, lots of large titan shards, I'd like to see that. One last item over here. Drang hammers, the entire Drang set is mine! Hopefully not at too great cost. That seems a good place to end the episode. We'll get back to that other spot in the next episode, I think. It's been 40 minutes or so. Gosh, I don't know. Maybe I should go a bit longer. Something to think about, I suppose. Oh wait, I have a better shortcut. What am I doing? I have the magical shortcut of this other side, which actually doesn't help me much. I can't remember. Was it through there? I think it was through there. Can't remember now. Wait, what's this? Oh. Hey, another one. What does it do? I don't think that does anything. I mean, it's kind of neat. Oh, maybe I have to open up this one too, wherever it is. Because I can see there's one here too. Does that get rid of the poison? I found that one on that side. Found that one behind everything. I don't think there's any hint as to where this last one is. Well, presumably last. Levers. Where are levers? That's the lever I just pulled. Yeah, okay. So it is reversible. Good to know. So one of the levers is right there. I wonder if there's an order. Like, I have to put some up and some down. That would kind of suck. Alright, and I don't see where the other one would be. Unless it's up... Oh, probably it's up there. Like, because if I get past those knights, then I'd be on that raised platform in the middle there. And this gate, or whatever it is probably attached to that platform. The lever's probably there. Keep an eye out for it, but I'm pretty sure that's where it is. And otherwise, I don't think there's much else. Alright, so back to the bonfire, I guess. I feel like back to Firelink. I'm just kind of curious, how many souls do I have? Solid. Alright, so I think Large of the Soul and Unknown Traveler is 1,000. So I think it's 1,000, 2,000. That's 6,000. That's 11,000. That's barely a level. It's a lot for barely a level. I don't think I'm going to go do that. But I did get a bunch of large shards, which means I have 4. Which means I can plus 5 something. Like a Saint's Talisman. I guess that's the only thing I have left other than the Claymore, which I'm not using at the moment, but no reason to abandon it as a result. I took the long way. Right, so it looks like giants do die and do not respawn, which is good. It looks like the other knights do respawn, which will be a slight pain in the butt when I'm done with the bonfire, although I do have a shortcut that's a better shortcut than the one I was taking, so I won't have to worry about the knights as much. And yes, in case you're wondering, I did that without dying. I probably should have embered up, but I did that without dying. Yay! I didn't die. I'm probably slightly overleveled for the area, but the important thing is I did not die. Oh yeah. Wait, so this shortcut leads me around... Where did the shortcut go to again? Oh! Wow, I was right there? I just had to go through this door rather than going all the way back up after finding the liver. Wow, that was a really roundabout route. Okay, well, at least I figured that out. That also means a bit less trouble with knights. There's still gonna be trouble with knights. This shortcut doesn't get past them. But hey, bit less trouble. Anyway, that is... I think that's going to be it, so I will... I can't think of anything else. If I'm missing anything in Firelink, I don't think so. I don't know. Anyhow, I'll leave you all here, so thanks for watching, and see you in the next one. Hey, this skirt is much better boots than the last one. Actually, the last one had sandals. This is proper boots. I think this is the skirt for me. Or about the closest approximation to the dingy skirt that I was using in Dark Souls 1.